Hello, super friends. Welcome to our fun day today. Day number three. As you can see, today I've changed my costume and now I am Thor. Do you guys know who Thor is? Well, Thor is a superhero and he has this hammer. And this hammer is supposed to be extra powerful, right? So he throws the hammer, whoosh, and gets the bad guys, and the hammer's supposed to come back to him. And he can swing it around really fast, and he throws it, and then it comes back. And he can also hold it up in the air, and lightning gets on it. Do you think I can do that? Let me hold it. Ready? No! No lightning. Okay, maybe if I throw it, it'll come back. What do you think? Ready? Superpowers. Man, that's fun. You know what though? There is something that gives us power. Did you know that? It's in the Bible. God sends the Holy Spirit to us to give us power. That's in our Bible verse today. Here's our coloring sheet in our Bible verse, and it says, the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus. Remember we talked about him, that from the dead dwells in you. So the same power that raised Jesus from the dead, remember that impossible thing from Monday? Impossible? Raised Jesus from the dead dwells in us. Dwells means lives. So that same power lives in me. Crazy, right? And in you. Today our Bible story is going to be about how two people named Peter and John, they were really good friends with Jesus, and they used the power from Jesus, from God, from the Spirit to heal someone. So we're going to learn that story today. But first, we're going to sing our songs. So I'll dance here at my house, and you dance at your house, and I'll see you back in a few minutes. All right, ready, set, go.
You are. don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. Oh my God, that is who you are.
My faith is dead, I need a resurrection.
sounds great. I love that music. All right, so remember how I told you that there was a story in the Bible about two people that used the power from the Holy Spirit? Well, here it is. So, our Bible verse for you one more time says, "The Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you." And that means that the Holy Spirit is inside of you and will give you power to do things. So today our story is about two of Jesus's friends, Peter and John. And they were Jesus's disciples, and they were with him all the time, and they were even with him when he died, and they saw him after he was risen from the dead. And they were there when the Holy Spirit came down on Pentecost and gave them the gift to speak to everyone. So one day, Peter and John are walking to the temple. Now, the temple is the place where the Israelites, the Jewish people, would go and worship, kind of like a church. So they were walking to temple, and they saw a man on the ground. And this man couldn't walk. He was born that way. And because he couldn't walk, he couldn't have a job. And so he had to sit by the temple gates every day and ask people to give him money. I'm sure that some of you have probably seen people like that, asking for money on the road. So he sat there and he asked for money every day. And when Peter and John walked by, Peter said, "I don't have any silver or gold to give you, but I do have the power of Jesus Christ. So stand up." And guess what happened? That man stood up because Peter used the power from Jesus Christ to heal that man. And that man jumped up and he was praising God. How do you think that he did it? Do you think he just stood there and said, "Thank you, Jesus"? Probably not. He probably jumped around and he was so excited. Can you do that? Can you jump around and say, yay, Jesus? That's probably what he did. So he praised Jesus, thanked Peter and John, and walked with them. And people came out and they said, "Hey, isn't that that guy that sits and asks for money? What happened?" And he got to tell his story. He got to tell how the power of Jesus was in Peter and John and how it healed him. I think it's a great story. So today we're going to make a craft about the Holy Spirit. So I'm going to get my craft stuff and you get your craft stuff and we'll meet right back here. Are you ready? Set. Man, that was so fast. You guys are getting faster at getting ready for craft time every day. So today, our Bible verse had to do with the Spirit, right? Do you know who the Spirit is? It's the other part of God, of the three parts of God. There's God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So today, we're going to make a craft to help us remember that the Spirit is with us. Now, usually when people talk about the Spirit in the Bible, it is portrayed as a dove. Portrayed means that it's how it's represented. So we can't really see the Spirit, but when God talks about the Spirit or when people see the Spirit, they talk about a dove. Like one example is when Jesus was being baptized in the river by his cousin John. The dove came from heaven and then God's voice came. So that the dove was the Spirit. So today we're going to make a dove. So what you need is you need your paper plate and you need some scissors, and you're going to need a grown-up to help you do this because cutting a paper plate is kind of tough. And you're going to need this paper. Now, if you don't have a paper plate, you can just use this and it will work. Okay, this one has words on it, says peace is, and you can do that if you want to, but if you cut it out of the paper plate, it won't have the words. So you're gonna cut it out. And what I did was I cut mine out and then I taped it to my paper plate to help it stay still while I cut. So then I cut out the body of the dove. See, there it is right there, the body of the dove. And then I have two wings. So I'm gonna put this down because I'm finished with that one. So now I have my body and my wings, right? And this is a super easy craft because we're just gonna stick it together. You can use tape, or glue or a stapler. That's what I'm gonna use because staplers are way easy. You might need a grown-up to help you. I forgot to look at the paper on how to put the wings on, so let's look. So right here in the picture, on your paper, you can see what the dove is gonna look like on the plate. And it has the round part on the body and it pointing up like this. So this wing goes like that. And the other wing goes on the other side, right? And you can position it. You can put them so that they're right next to each other, or you can make it so that you can see all of them at once. See how I did that? I just moved it over a little. Now here's the easy part. If you're gluing it, you'll have to put glue on each of the pieces in the middle. If you're taping it, you just put a piece of tape on it. If you're stapling it, you just go like this. Ta-da! I made a dove. And I'm gonna give my dove an eye with my crayon. I'm just gonna do an eye on both sides, just a little black eyeball. If you want to, you could even color the beak. And that's it. That's my dove. And I'm going to hang it on my wall with my other stuff. I know that you guys might have seen it. I posted a picture of my crafts hanging on the wall. I posted the craft on one side and the Bible verse on the other. And that's what I'll do with these today too. So I hope you guys are doing that so you can remember all of your lessons. Because remember, we made the camel because nothing is impossible with God, right? Not even a camel going through a needle. And Jesus coming back, right? That was the most impossible thing we talked about. Then we talked about how God keeps his promises, and he keeps his promises, kept his promise to Abraham, and Abraham got lots of descendants, and he also kept his promise to Noah that he wouldn't flood the earth again. So we made a rainbow. Do you remember? And today we made a dove to remind us of God's helper, the Holy Spirit, coming on us. And the Holy Spirit gives us lots of things. It gives us power. It gives us peace. It gives us comfort. And so the Holy Spirit is super important. So we're going to hang him up too, our little dove, with our other stuff. Now, are you guys ready to sing our song, our superhero song, the favorite song? Well, we're going to do that in just a second. I'm going to put my stuff away and we'll sing, okay? Hey, are you guys ready to sing our song? I love this one, but I know you know that, and I hope you enjoy it too. So let's fly like a superhero. Are you ready?
I can fly around like a superhero and know I'm strong cause God loves me. I can march on forward every day and not be afraid cause God's with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days a week. I can count on God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 days a week. I can count on God.
You ready to jump?
I can jump.
Fly around.
I can always count on God. My God is number one. I can
ready to say our prayer and say goodbye for today? All right, let's put our hands together and let's talk to God. Dear God, we thank you for this Bible school, that even when we can't come to Bible school can come to us, and that is so awesome. We thank you for our parents and other grown-ups that are helping us this week to learn about you. We thank you, God, that nothing is impossible with you. We thank you that you are faithful to your promises. And we are thankful for your Spirit, Father, and for the power that it gives us. We love you, God. Amen. Okay, friends, I will see you tomorrow for our last day of Bible school. All right, bye-bye.